Guys, this is a big moment. The question, what does Einstein, a glass of wine, and the modern rogue have in common? You may think you know the answer, but you don't. Because the real answer is Brandt Hughes, the third voice that has been there from the beginning of the modern rogue. You've seen him checking our facts. You've seen him calling us out. You've seen him doing science minutes. He is a curious mind with an extraordinary storytelling voice. And I can't be more pleased to announce that he's starting his own channel now. It's called Emergent Beacon, and I want you to subscribe totally blind. If you trust me, just subscribe right now on the link below. If you're somebody who needs a little bit of seduction, take just a moment and experience what an unfettered Brandt Hughes looks like. It sounded dirtier than I meant to.
The vastness of the cosmos is home to unexpected outcomes, unseen observers, and improbable anomalies. Despite knowing that, despite embodying its very truth, maybe even for that reason, I can't help but be inescapably paired to any sort of phenomenon that's as rare as I am. And I found just such a thing. This is an Einstein cross. I was scanning through Wikipedia, where I got distracted by this photo. It was simply described as a cosmic mirage, where these four surrounding spots were all actually the same object. Curious. To me, one of the beautiful truisms of science is that any sort of surprising result clearly exposes an incomplete understanding of the mechanics that led to that outcome. So if I find something like this that I don't particularly understand very well, I'm gonna start speculating. So my first thought is, if I'm looking through a telescope and I happen to observe four identical objects in the sky that maybe are the same thing, I'm thinking, you know what? Maybe there's a scratch in the optics or something, giving me a little bit of a blurred double vision, because let's just be honest, that's a more plausible explanation. But we probably wouldn't even be talking about this if it just amounted to user error or bad glass. So I think we can safely rule those explanations out. I can see other galaxies just fine, and other astronomers, they can see the same anomaly as I do. So we should probably get around to actually confirming that these four different objects are from the same source. Otherwise, this video would kind of just be, I saw four different things in the sky, and you could probably do that right now.
And we can try to confirm that these are duplicates with this really clever technique called spectroscopy, where they measure the spectrum of light coming from a source. It's important to remember that every celestial body we can see is detected by a combination of emitting light, reflecting light, and absorbing light. The resulting spectrum of light can help identify cosmic bodies and establish a variety of properties of those materials, whether they be stars, planets, nebulae, galaxies, and whatever else might be out there. We can also use these readouts to establish its redshift, which is when the frequency of light gets elongated. This is used in cosmology to determine an object's distance and movement. In this case, a spectroscopic analysis reasonably confirms that the redshifted images that we're looking at are a quasar. And what do you know? They are the same quasar.
Now, I should probably tell you that this whole time, those clever astronomers, they already had a pretty good idea of what was going on. And despite how convincing an idea it may be, four galaxy-sized mirrors just isn't that feasible. So what else could there be? Well, there's a hint in the name. Einstein cross might have a little something to do with, you guessed it, Jesus. That can't be right. I mean, he did have a few things to say about Jesus, but here it is. Sorry, I misread that. That's so embarrassing. Relativity. The thing that Einstein was always going on about. This is actually one of a few natural consequences that arose out of general relativity, and it's called light deflection by means of gravitational lensing. General relativity provides a framework for how we view space-time such that it gives a really useful description of how gravity works. Matter distorts the curvature of space-time, and objects naturally fall along that shape in what are called geodesics, which are, if we're simplifying, they're about the closest thing you can get to straight lines when looking at an irregularly shaped space-time. So from our perspective, it looks like light takes a curved path to us when passing near massive objects. because the light is following its geodesic that dips into the curvature of that spacetime and goes fast enough to escape that massive object's sphere of influence. All of this to say, the path of light is affected by gravity.
The path of light being influenced by the gravity of massive objects was theorized, in part, as early as the late 1700s. Back then, it was in the context of early ideas of black holes, which were then called dark stars. However, this ended up being a rudimentary description as it was constrained by Newtonian physics. It wasn't until Einstein's general theory of relativity was published in 1915 that scientific theory had culminated in a rigorous enough tool set to be able to more reliably describe this interaction.
What we're seeing here is a quasar hiding behind a nearby galaxy. The galaxy is known as Hooker's lens, which is the hazy point of light in the center of this image. You can see the structure of that galaxy a little bit better with this photo. The warped spacetime of that galaxy is redirecting the light from the quasar that would otherwise travel right past us back to Earth from four apparent sources. Quasars are supermassive black holes that develop accretion disks where a bunch of space junk just falls into it and heats up so much that in the more extreme cases can radiate the same amount of light as 1,000 galaxies.
So for some of you, that is a mystery solved. Oh, what is this mysterious duplicate object in the sky? Well, it's an Einstein cross. It's light being bent by gravity. Okay, that's cool. But the rest of you might still feel compelled to investigate a little bit further, as I certainly did. What are some of the implications of this idea? What else can this look like? When was this discovered? And why did Einstein not take it seriously? These are all explored in the full video over on the Emergent Beacon channel. And it would mean a whole lot to me personally if you all went over there to check it out. It took an extraordinarily long amount of time and a whole lot of effort to put together. Now, to be clear, I have no formal education in astrophysics. I'm just a guy with an art degree from a community college. But I think in some ways, this was a result of the modern rogue mentality that no matter how oblivious you may be to any one given topic, you can always find some path forward to pursue a deeper understanding of it. For the longtime viewers of Modern Rogue, you may recognize this style of video as being pretty similar to some of my occasional, sometimes sciencey research interjections. Well, Emergent Beacon is a space where I can follow that spark of curiosity to wherever it may lead me. And I think if you've enjoyed those segments over the years, you'll probably like this show too. If you, however, have not enjoyed those segments, well, I at least appreciate you for giving this a shot and watching along this far. Thank you all for your time, and as always, exercise empathy, work on your communication skills, and do your best.